YouTube, what's up? We are back. We are in my truck today in the mountains, in the middle of nowhere. I have no clue where we are, to be honest. But today we are gonna continue the series on the endless walkthrough. This is episode 4 today, I believe. And the goal of today is to see if we can clear floor 1000. Now, in the mind of some of you, it is very clear. But if you have any doubts with the current strat that we have, you will see if we can do it or not. I'm not going to take too much of your time. I want to thank you again for 1000 subs. The next video is going to be about the new series that I was talking about in the last video. And we're going to start checking all those legendaries and see if they are good in Endless. This is going to be it for me on the intro side. I hope you guys are going to have fun watching the video. Like the video if you do. And if you like the series as well. And sub to the channel if it's your second time here. Okay, new day, new me, as they say. Today, we are gonna do a quick recap of the items and what we are looking for. I want you to remember what you are looking for specifically. Today, we have Mega Gyarados, as usual. We have Mold Breaker and Multiscale. Doesn't matter, to be honest, too much for the Mold Breaker. It's gonna be good against like sturdy Pokemons, but you know, it doesn't really matter, to be honest. We have those items, so we still don't have any berry pouches, or I think we might have one. We have most of the berries we can restock anyways. We have a Reviver Seed that we can move to Gengar just in case we don't find one. We have a 3 Grip Claws, which is okay. 2 Quick Claws, 1 Focus Band, and we have 7 Suldus, which is absolutely insane. 1 Wide Lens, and I think my Cloyster has 2 Multi-Lens, which is great as well. So, what do we need now? Well, we have the Eternatus Killer as well, which is the Fairy Steel type with Super Fang. And we have the quote-unquote pickup Pokemon that's currently the support, quote-unquote support. I guess it's more of a curse bot for now for the bigger bosses. And Lumineon is here later on for Soak because we want to start making the Dot Pokemon, which is what we are doing right now. We don't really need to make anything specific with Gengar. Only Curse is sufficient for now. So I am currently working on making the daughter. So we made Lilligant at the beginning to have specifically Leech Seed. And Lumineon is going to be for Soak. So Lumineon has Soak. And now we are looking for a Leech Seeder and Super Fanger, or whatever you want to call it. Salcure as well. So we are looking for Garganacle currently. But for now, we are just progressing into the game, looking for some items, and yeah, that's pretty much it. I'm just gonna speed up until we find something. It's gonna be that point now where we are gonna speed the game up a lot, because there is really nothing else to say. We have the development of the Pokemon, we are past level 500, we have the Eternatus Killer, so there is really no danger. It's gonna be a lot of skipping around now. Not skipping, I'm just gonna speed up the game, and then I'm gonna talk about stuff that we find. And stuff that we can talk about for the strats. But it basically, now it's just about progressing and finding Pokemon that we need for the later fusions. Oh yeah, I wanted to say before we go into the speed up, we have money right now. We have 720k, which is okay. Obviously, we can find more. We are at a point now where we can reroll a couple of times every single shop. So I'm trying to reroll like 1, 2, 3 times every single shop. And I'm trying to go for, if I can't get like a candy, I'm trying to get for the Relic Gold. So Relic Gold is actually very nice. We have 2 Amulet Coins. We are still looking for those. But for items, we are looking for red items. And we are looking otherwise for candies or money. That's the goal right now. So I'm going to take the Relic Gold. So we jump to 1.3 million, which is double our money right now. And yeah, we should be fine. Otherwise, we can use, so when you're looking for a move specifically, so I was looking some Factorio here. I don't think you guys care too much. So we have the Pokédex. It is online now. When you're looking for moves specifically, if we're looking for Leech Seed, for example, we can see here. So if we check the game, we can see Bellossom. So if you want to check if Bellossom has Leech Seed, we can tap Bello. And as you can see, Bellossom does not have Leech Seed. And we're looking for Super Fang. But most of the time, Super Fang is going to be available on Pokémon that have Fangs. Quote-unquote fangs, not all the time of course, but most of the time it's gonna be the case. And for Salcure, we are looking for Garganacle. That's literally it. The thing is, we might want to fuse into Garganacle last, because most of the time Garganacle has Sturdy, which is what we're looking for here, okay? We'll see how it goes. If we find Garganacle, then so be it. We'll just change our strategy. But we're making the Daughter right now, just for a later phase of the game when Gyarados is not gonna be enough anymore. All right, let's go into the speed up and I'm gonna take you back whenever we find something interesting. All right, so I guess we did find something useful very early on. So those berry pouches are very important. If you are currently at floor 500-ish and you have all your berry pouches, pay attention to your pickup Pokemon because you want to start distributing those berries. What you want to do is spread all those berries to all your Pokemons, at least 3 of them. And once you have all your berry pouches and all your berries on 3 Pokemons, you can actually get rid of your pickup Pokemon. This is why I merge Gengar with Zigzagoon, because at some point I'm just gonna remove Zigzagoon. So we're taking the berry pouch here, of course, and I want to just remind you how the shop works. If we have a good shop on the first round or the second round, we are gonna lock rarities to look for those red items. Alright, we have a candidate for Leech Seed. We are gonna try to not kill it, so I'm just gonna try to capture it. To be honest, it's gonna be annoying. I'm pretty sure I'm gonna watch it whatever happens, so... I mean, to be honest, I could just swap to something else. Okay, never mind. You don't have Leech Seed, which is... Okay, well, we have a Mushroom, so... As you can see, Leech Seed is here. Now, do we have anything else that we need on this Pokemon? Not really. We are looking, as I said, for Super Fang. The Worry Seed is technically a good move, but not on the Daughter, to be honest. So now what we are looking for is... Actually, when you think about it, Leech Seed is not necessarily something that we could get on Lumineon is pretty useless to get right now. Because the moveset for the Daughter is gonna be very simple. It's gonna be Salcure, Leech Seed, Super Fang, Protect. We could do Salcure, Soak, Protect, Super Fang, and then use Leech Seed on something else. Like we could use Leech Seed on the Gengar, for example. Yeah, we're gonna use Soak on the support, actually. Alright, so I'm gonna teach Leech Seed. There you go. This way, whenever we have a DNA Splicer, we can technically make the fusion. I'm actually gonna remove Lumineon, because we're gonna need it later. So what I need right now is someone with Super Fang or someone with Salcure, which is Garganacle, right, obviously. All right, so I'm gonna capture Linoon, because Linoon can technically learn Super Fang. I just need to find the TM for it. So I'm either gonna find the Pokemon with Super Fang, or I'm gonna find the TM. It's one or the other. Second berry pouch, by the way. Okay, so technically we could get Roserade and Linoon together, because we can still teach Super Fang to the fusion of Roserade and Linoon. So I'm gonna fuse them together. I don't need to teach anything, basically, to my fusion right now. I just need to find the TM, and we should be okay. So we have Rose 1, which is a grayed out Roserade, and we have Lich Seed, of course, and we are looking for Super Fang still. Just in case we get the TM, it would be good to get it on this Pokemon right now. And we can still learn the TM anyways, because we can get the TM from the two Pokemons. Okay, so we have Protect, so I'm gonna learn Protect to Roserade and my Linoon. This way we have it for the future. Protect is pretty hard to find, even though it's a normal TM. It is still something that's hard to find for some reason. So now we have half of the build, which is nice. We are still looking for Super Fang and a Garganacle. Oh, there you go. We have Super Fang, and now we can actually teach Super Fang. Wow. This is actually pretty lucky when it comes to TMs right now. Even though those are white TMs, of course. It is still pretty lucky to get all of those in a row. Wow, okay. We found the second berry pouch earlier and now we have the third berry pouch. That is pretty cool. So now all the berries are always gonna be not consumed. So if you weren't aware, a single berry pouch basically had a 33% chance that a used berry will not be consumed. So if we have 3 berry pouches, we have 100% chance of a berry to not be consumed. And in this case, since we have the third one, now every berry that we give to any Pokemons are never going to be consumed. So this is the point now where we're going to start gaining all those berries. We are never going to lose any of them. And we are just going to distribute them to 3 Pokemons. And when we have all the berries, and we find some Pokemon we can fuse with Gengar, we are gonna get rid of Zigzagoon. Alright, new day, new game, new 1 hour, I guess. This is what you have so far. I'm just gonna show you really quick. We still need King's Rock, we still need multi-lenses, we still need proteins, we still need a lot of things, to be honest. But again, just a reminder, don't forget to get all your items from your pickup Pokemon, if you have to, on your main, very important. Right, we are making the Daughter Follet game. So currently, we are looking for a Soak Pokemon. Actually, no, we are not looking for Soak. We're looking for Salcure right now. Okay. I'm just trying to remind myself what we need. We're looking for Salcure. Let's talk about Eternatus once again, if you guys didn't understand how it works. It is basically always the same. We are gonna curse. Or we can just go into Grumble, it is up to you. Again, the strat was to put curse and then go into grumble or gradil in this case. So we're gonna do the exact same. We are gonna do curse. He's actually missing, which is interesting. I'm going to just attack him. He's gonna kill me anyways. There you go. The reviver seed was just in case. Now we have everything. We're gonna go into the wall. We are gonna sandstorm. Just because why not? And then we super fang. There you go. He's gonna be damaged by curse. And he's gonna be damaged by super fang. And he's just gonna die. That's it. There you go. Super fang. And he's dead. Sandstorm plus curse plus super fang. He is dead. Easy peasy. This is how the fight with Eternatus is always gonna go. It's always gonna be the same. It's always gonna be that free. There is no reason to be scared about him. And now we go back to Gyarados. We go back to the combo. Alright, we are back, and now we have all the King's Rock. I got the last one, last fight. So what we're gonna do, since we are playing a flinching build, we are gonna trade the multi-lens on my Cloyster and move them to my Gyarados. The reason we are doing this is because, again, we are playing a flinch build, we are playing Bites, Waterfall, and I'm actually gonna look for Ice Fang as well now. The goal is basically to look for that Ice Fang, as I said, there you go. We're gonna remove Ice Spinner. This way, most of our attacks now are gonna flinch all the time, okay? And Multi-Lens is also great for shields. So if we meet any boss, it's gonna be way easier to actually beat Pokemon with shields. I'm actually gonna try and find one right now. If we get into it, see, we actually hit four times. And most of the time, we're gonna flinch because that's what the spells are doing. So we are still looking for those red items, of course, obviously. We do have a splicer, but the splicer is gonna be useless in this case because we still didn't find the Garganacle, right? So I've been using items on my Rose One as well because that's the next carry. But I'm actually gonna move the multi-lens on my flinch support. And I need to move my King's Rock on Cloyster as well. Whenever we get more, right? So I'm gonna take Rose One. I don't remember if we have like any moves that have low accuracy. I'm pretty sure we do. Yeah, Rock Blast has a 90 accuracy. So we do need a couple of wide lenses. But in this case, it's gonna have to wait. I'm just gonna give you the multi-lens. There you go. And we need another one. But yeah. At this point, at 800, you should basically look for still those red items and start looking for putting all the berries on all your characters. This way, we can ditch the pickup Pokemon and then we can start scaling with candy jars. That's the goal. There is no way, right? So when I play and I'm not like saying anything, I usually mute the sound, so give me a second. So we are in the lab. I never get into the lab. It's actually quite funny. I wonder if we're gonna meet anything. There is a big chance that we do not find anything, to be honest. But it's always interesting to go into the lab. We had more chance of the lab spawning in the last updates, but damn, that's funny. Because I did a endless run recently and I didn't actually find the lab. So it is funny. In the lab, you don't really have a lot of Pokemon that are new. It's mainly about the legendaries that you find here. So if we get lucky and we find a legendary, it would be nice, but we are probably not gonna find one. Definitely. It's only, you only stay in those biomes for like 2 to 4 floors. So most of the time we are gonna get out right now or in the next floor, and we're just gonna not find anything, basically. We already found 2 bosses as well, so there is a very small chance of actually finding anything. And there you go. So we have nothing. So next fight, we are moving back to the plains, basically. But very interesting that we actually went into the lab. Alright, let's go. I didn't say how to prepare for it, so I'm gonna say this again. This is the same preparation as in the last Eternatus fight. All of them are the same because the move set is the same. There is no flamethrower. There is no moves different. I mean, obviously, if you watch this in the future, this might be different, but yeah. So, Gengar with Reviver Seed, we go into Curse. There you go. So we die, that's okay. He's gonna be cursed. There you go. And now, guess what? I guess we could technically go into Rose 1, Leech Seed, but we are just gonna go into Gradrill and we're gonna do Sandstorm. Obviously, he's gonna steal some of our items, but it doesn't matter because we literally have nothing. We have a Reviver Seed, which could be annoying if he takes it, but again, it's not gonna change anything. So now, all we do, we let Curse do its thing. We spam Super Fang, and we let the boss die, kill itself, basically. There you go. Look at this. Look at the life go down. Look at his health. He's gonna die. There you go. I guess one more hit. There you go. He's dead. And that was 1k. Again, having Eternatus Killer, having Super Fang, and having Curse is more than enough for the first 2,000 floors. You don't need to have more than this. Gengang. Oh, the name is cute. When it comes to the items in the future, now that we are at 1k, most of the items, we have them. Right. We have the King's Rock, we have the Wildlands, we have the Leftovers, we have the Shell Bell, we have the Focus Band, Grip Claw, Quick Claw. We just need some proteins, of course, but that's gonna come with the time. We have Multilens on our Flincher. We have 2 multilens, 2 wide lens, we need more King's Rock, so this is not over yet. But it's okay, for this part of the game, it doesn't matter too much. For this Pokemon, we did absolutely nothing, because this guy is only here to kill Eternatus. This is Gengagoon, obviously this is gonna change in the future, but this guy doesn't need anything as well, because he's, or maybe Quick Claw. Actually, even, no, you don't really need Quick Claw. Because you are gonna be Prankster in the future. So the only thing we need on this Pokemon is the moveset, basically. And lastly, we have Rose 1. So this guy, we are still looking for Garganacle, right, to teach Salcure. And yes, we need Soak on Gengar instead of Leech Seed. So we need Curse and Soak. Obviously, this is gonna be in the future. We still need those. This is the list that we need for the future Pokémons. We are pretty close to be done. You know, some runaway or something like this to complete the team. But for now, we are gonna be done. So this is gonna be it for this video. We are at 1,000. We are pretty close to finishing, for sure. Only 5,000 floors to go, right? But this is going great. We are not that lucky. We have a couple of candy jars. We have a couple of items. I think this is a very average run when it comes to luck. I have been way more lucky than this. And I have been having a worse luck as well. Thank you guys for watching. Like the video if you like it. Follow this series if you like it as well. Subscribe to the channel. And I will see you in the next one. Bye.